Hey there, Junior Kids. Once again, I'm here with yet another class, and this is our EVS class, Environmental Studies. And this whole month, we are learning about good manners and etiquette. So, for being a good person, we need to practice the good manners along with etiquette. Okay, today we are going to learn about positive personality traits. You might be thinking, what is positive personality trait? So for that, I'm going to ask you some question. Which moment makes you very special? Or which moment do you like? Or which moment do you love a lot? It may be your birthday. It may be the newborn siblings, welcoming of newborn siblings in your house. It may be a get-together party in your house. It may be a picnic or a tour. Okay, so all this moment we like a lot. Why? Because we feel treasured, we feel loved, we feel cared by our family members, our parents, or all our siblings, our cousins and all. So we like to be loved and cared for. There are people in our family, those who want like to be loved and cared. Okay, so can you tell me who are the people that need love and care from you also? So they may be your parents, your grandparents, or your little brother or sister. Because early in the morning, what does mama do? Mama wakes up, she makes us ready for the school, she prepares our breakfast, and then she keeps everything ready. Okay, she ensures that whether everything has been done to us correctly or not. Okay, so this is all her responsibility towards us. Okay. She shows her responsibility that our all the needs have been fulfilled or not. And so we need to thank for it. It's very important, because if we need love and care from others, then they also need the same love and care for themselves. So for being a good person, positive personality trait means being a good person. What we have to do, we have to love, care, share, and be responsible towards the people, those who love us, those who care for us, those who share everything with us, those who are responsibility towards our fulfillment. Okay, so we need to thank them, we need to care for them, we need to love them. So it may be your mother, it may be your father, it may be your grandparent, or it may be your brothers or sister. So we need to give them thanks, because we need to thank them, because they always help us to do our work, to make our needs fulfilled. Okay, so for this, what we are going to do, we couldn't say simply thank you. Instead of saying simply thank you, we can make a card, a thank you card for and we can present that. Okay, children. So today we are going to make a pop-up takeaway card. Okay, it's a pop-up takeaway card. So I'm going to show you. So you have a takeaway cover. From the takeaway cover, you need to take this card and a cutout of rainbow. So this is the cutout of rainbow, children. So what you have to do, you have to color it. Okay, so these are the clouds. The bottom one, starting with the violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange, red. You need to color this rainbow. And here, if you have cotton in your house, you could stick the cotton like I have did. You can have a look on this. So this is the rainbow. See, I had stick the cotton in the clouds and then I had colored the rainbow. Isn't that so beautiful? Yes, very good. Okay, next what we are going to do is, this card is simply plain. If you want, you can add some details to this card, such as you could make some clouds over here. you can make the raindrops, clouds and raindrops. Okay, that's our own creativity work. You can do anything, whatever you want. Okay, next here we need to write thank you. We need to write thank you. Here we need to write thank you. So here we need to write thank you. One I had made. So I'm going to show you my card and my creativity work. So you could see that I had made a cloud and I had stick the cloud with cotton, white color cotton. I had stick the white color cotton in the cloud cut out, and after that I had cut the tip of buds, earbuds tip. I had cut and stick it like as it is raining, and here I had written thank you. I had written thank you. So parent, you can write thank you, because kid may write or kid may not write, but if kid writes by themselves, then it will be a good job. So what we are going to do is, we are going to stick this rainbow in the card. Okay, I'm going to show you now how to stick. So this is a pop-up card, so I have applied the gum here, this folding, and I am going to stick the rainbow now. Look at this, I am going to stick the rainbow here. So how is this now? Backside, okay, you could see that it's raining at the backside and the rainbow is there, and thank you is also written. When you close, it will bend. When you open, it will come out. So this is called pop-up card, pop-up thank you card. So today we have made pop-up thank you card in concept time. So this is how you could make the this one. Actually, it is our own creativity. If you want, you can make this, or not, you can leave it also. Okay, this is our very own creativity. So this is actually my creativity. You can make it or you can leave it also, but if you make it, then it will be very beautiful. You can display this card in your house also. After making this card, children, give this card to your parent and say them thank you for everything. You have thank you for your love, your care, your support, and then your responsibility towards me. So thank you, mommy. Like that, you have to say and present this card to your parent. Okay, now let's do the worksheet. What worksheet we are going to do is, so let's see, you have to open this page. So parent, please do write today's date and name. So here, look at the pictures and understand the manners and etiquettes you need to practice. So as I said, that this whole month we are learning about good manners and etiquettes. Okay, so for being a good person, good children, we need to practice all the good manners and etiquettes. So what are the good manners and etiquettes given in the picture? All these good manners and etiquettes we have to follow. Okay, the first picture is be kind. You have to be kind. See kids, you may have siblings in your house, or the younger brother or the younger sister in your house. So you want to play with them, you can play, but not rudely, play softly. You should be kind with your brothers or sister. The second picture is be safe. So always be safe, because you never go outside without your parents' permission, or you never talk to strangers. So be safe. Next, use quiet voices. It's really very bad when you scream out in the house. That shows you're angry. Okay, don't show your anger. Don't throw your anger tantrums and all in your house. So be quiet. Use quiet voices. Okay. Next, be responsible. It's very, very important, children, because in your house, you're playing with so many toys. You do have toys. What you have to do after playing? You have to place back the toys from where you have taken it. Okay, in school, after playing free play corner, what do we do? We do the cleanup, isn't it? Why do we do the cleanup? Because it's our responsibility. We play with that toys. So it's our responsibility to clean it up after playing. Okay. So next, be forgiving. Okay. Always be forgiving. No matter if somebody hits you, no matter if somebody snatches your things, okay, you should not fight for that. Okay, you can forgive him or her. Okay, finally, hands to yourself. Okay, whenever we go outside in a bike or in a car or in a bus, we have to keep our hands to ourselves. We should not always play like this, play like that. We should not stretch our hands out of the bus. Or when we are sitting in a, sitting among the people, we should not do the naughty acts. Okay, we should keep our hands to ourselves only. So these are the some good manners and etiquettes that we have to follow for being a good person. So children, I hope that this whole month we had learned this good manners and etiquettes, and you will follow and practice all the things that I have taught you, and you will be a good person. Okay, so until with yet another new concept, I am going to meet you in the next EVS class. Until then, it's your auntie saying bye and take care.